Service Teardown, HP 268 Pro G1 MT. How to replace the wireless LAN antennas. Removal. Unscrew both wireless LAN antenna cables from the external connectors on the wireless LAN card. Remove the wireless LAN antennas. Replacement. Screw both wireless LAN antenna cables onto the external connectors on the wireless LAN card. How to replace the access panel. Removal. Loosen the thumb screw on the rear edge of the access panel. Slide the access panel toward the rear of the chassis. Lift the access panel straight up and off the chassis and remove. Replacement. Insert the hooks on the access panel into the cutouts in the chassis. Slide the access panel toward the front of the chassis until it is secured into position. Tighten the thumb screw on the rear edge of the access panel. How to replace the optical drive. Before you begin, remove the access panel. Removal. Disconnect the power and data cables from the optical drive. Press down on the optical drive tray release latch and slide the optical drive toward the front of the unit. Slide the optical drive out of the cutout in the front bezel and remove. Replacement. Slide the optical drive into the cutout in the front bezel until the optical drive bezel is flush and the release latch clicks. Connect the data and power cables to the optical drive. How to replace the front bezel. Before you begin, remove the access panel. Removal. Release the three retention clips that secure the top edge of the front bezel to the chassis. Rotate the front bezel downward, remove it from the connectors on the motherboard, and rest it in front of the chassis. Disconnect the power button board cable from the connector on the power button board. Remove the front bezel. Replacement. Place the front bezel in front of the chassis. Connect the power button board cable into the connector on the power button board. Tow the tabs on the bottom edge of the front bezel into the cutouts in the chassis. Slide it onto the connectors on the motherboard and press in on the top edge to snap the retention clips into place. How to replace the power button board. Before you begin, remove the access panel and front bezel. Removal. Remove the two 7mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the power button board to the front bezel. Lift the power button board off the front bezel and remove. Replacement. Place the power button board into position on the front bezel. Replace the two 7mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the power button board to the front bezel. How to replace the 3.5-inch storage drive. Before you begin, remove the access panel. Removal. Disconnect the power and data cables from the storage drive. While supporting the storage drive, remove the four 9mm T15 Torx head screws that secure the storage drive to the drive cage. Slide the storage drive out from under the drive cage and remove. Replacement. Slide the storage drive under the drive cage and align the screw holes on the storage drive with the screw holes on the drive cage. While supporting the storage drive, replace the four 9mm T15 Torx head screws that secure the storage drive to the drive cage. Connect the data and power cables to the storage drive. How to replace the 2.5-inch storage drive. Before you begin, remove the access panel. Removal. Disconnect the power and data cables from the storage drive. While supporting the storage drive, remove the four 7mm T15 Torx head screws that secure the storage drive to the drive cage. Slide the storage drive out from under the drive cage and remove. Replacement. Slide the storage drive under the drive cage and align the screw holes on the storage drive with the screw holes on the drive cage. While supporting the storage drive, replace the four 7mm T15 Torx head screws that secure the storage drive to the drive cage. Connect the data and power cables to the storage drive. How to replace the drive cage. Before you begin, remove the access panel, optical drive, 3.5-inch storage drive, and 2.5-inch storage drive. Removal. Disconnect the storage drive power cable from the connector on the motherboard. Remove the 4 9mm T15 Torx head screws that secure the drive cage to the chassis. Slide the drive cage toward the center of the chassis. Lift the drive cage straight up and out until you have access to the SATA cable connectors on the motherboard. Disconnect the SATA cables from the connectors on the motherboard. Remove the drive cage. Replacement. Important. If you are replacing the drive cage, remove the SATA cables from the old drive cage and install on the new drive cage. Place the drive cage onto the chassis so that you have access to the SATA connectors on the motherboard. Connect the SATA cables into the connectors on the motherboard. Align the tabs on the drive cage with the notches on the chassis and lower the drive cage into position on the chassis. Slide the drive cage toward the front of the chassis. Replace the 4 9mm T15 Torx head screws that secure the drive cage to the chassis. Connect the storage drive power cable into the connector on the motherboard. How to replace the wireless LAN card. Before you begin, remove the access panel, optical drive, 3.5-inch storage drive, 2.5-inch storage drive, and drive cage. Removal. Disconnect the wireless LAN card cable from the connector on the motherboard. Rotate the expansion card retention bracket until it is fully open. Carefully slide the wireless LAN card straight up and out of the slot on the motherboard and remove it from the chassis. Important: if you are not replacing the wireless LAN card with another card, cover the open slot in the chassis with a metal slot cover. Replacement. Align the wireless LAN card with the slot on the motherboard and insert the wireless LAN card until it is fully seated. Rotate the expansion card retention bracket until it clicks closed. Connect the wireless LAN card cable into the connector on the motherboard. How to replace the system fan. Before you begin, remove the access panel, optical drive, 3.5-inch storage drive, 2.5-inch storage drive, and drive cage. Removal. Disconnect the fan cable from the motherboard. While supporting the fan, remove the two 10mm P2 Phillips head screws securing the fan to the chassis. Lift and remove the fan. Replacement. Position the fan against the chassis and align the screw holes. While supporting the fan, replace the two 10mm P2 Phillips head screws securing the fan to the chassis. Reconnect the fan cable to the motherboard. How to replace the M.2 solid-state drive. Before you begin, remove the access panel, optical drive, 3.5-inch storage drive, 2.5-inch storage drive, and drive cage. Removal. Remove the 3mm P1 Phillips head screw that secures the solid-state drive to the motherboard and allow it to release to the spring tension position. Grasp the solid-state drive by the edges and pull gently to remove it from the slot on the motherboard. Replacement. Align the notch in the solid-state drive with the key in the solid-state drive slot on the motherboard. At an angle, gently insert the solid-state drive into its slot on the motherboard. Replace the 3mm P1 Phillips head screw that secures the solid-state drive to the motherboard. How to replace the memory modules. Before you begin, remove the access panel, optical drive, 3.5-inch storage drive, 2.5-inch storage drive, and drive cage. Removal. Push down and out on the memory slot latches to release the memory module. Slide the memory module up and out of the memory slot and remove. Replacement. Important. When installing the memory module, be sure to align the notch in the memory module with the key in the memory module slot in the motherboard. Do not install the memory at an angle or in a sloping direction. It must be inserted straight into the connector. Align the notch in the memory module with the key in the memory module slot on the motherboard and insert the memory module. Press down on the memory module until the memory slot latches lock and the memory module is fully seated. How to replace the power supply. Before you begin, remove the access panel, optical drive, 3.5-inch storage drive, 2.5-inch storage drive, and drive cage. Removal. Disconnect all power supply cables from the motherboard. Remove the power supply cables from the retention clips on the chassis. Remove the 3 9mm T15 Torx head screws that secure the power supply to the chassis. Press the retention tab down and slide the power supply forward to release it from the retention clip on the chassis. Remove the power supply from the chassis. Replacement. Align the power supply with the retention clip on the chassis and lower it into place. Slide the power supply back until the retention tab clicks into place. Route the power supply cables through the routing clips on the chassis. Replace the 3 9mm T15 Torx head screws that secure the power supply to the chassis. Connect all power supply cables to the motherboard. How to replace the thermal fan. Before you begin, remove the access panel, optical drive, 3.5-inch storage drive, 2.5-inch storage drive, and drive cage. Removal. Disconnect the fan cable from the motherboard. Loosen the 4 captive P1 Phillips head screws securing the fan to the heatsink. Lift the fan off the heatsink and remove. Replacement. Using the orientation aids etched into the fan bracket, place the fan into position on the heatsink. Tighten the 4 P1 Phillips head screws securing the fan to the heatsink. Reconnect the fan cable to the motherboard. How to replace the heatsink. Before you begin, remove the access panel, optical drive, 3.5-inch storage drive, 2.5-inch storage drive, drive cage, and thermal fan. Removal. Note, the heatsink has numbers adjacent to the following 4 screws. Loosen the 4 captive T15 Torx head screws that secure the heatsink over the processor in numerical order. Lift the heatsink straight up and off of the processor and remove it from the chassis. Replacement. Using an alcohol swab, carefully remove the thermal grease from the heatsink and processor. According to the individual specifications for your particular processor, apply new thermal grease to the processor. Align the screw holes on the heatsink with the standoffs on the motherboard and lower the heatsink into position over the processor. Tighten the 4 T15 Torx head screws that secure the heatsink over the processor in numerical order. How to replace the motherboard. Before you begin, remove the access panel, optical drive, front bezel, expansion cards, wireless LAN card, system fan, M.2 solid-state drive, 3.5-inch storage drive, 2.5-inch storage drive, drive cage, memory modules, thermal fan, and heatsink. Removal. Important. Make careful note of the location of all cables connected to the motherboard for later replacement. Disconnect all cables from the connectors on the motherboard. Remove the 8 9mm T15 Torx head screws that secure the motherboard to the chassis. Carefully lift on the front edge of the motherboard and slide the rear external connectors out of the cutouts in the chassis. Remove the motherboard from the chassis. Replacement. At an angle, slide the rear external connectors on the motherboard into the cutouts in the chassis and lower the motherboard into position. Replace the 8 9mm T15 Torx head screws that secure the motherboard to the chassis. Connect all cables into the connectors on the motherboard. Important! After motherboard replacement, be sure to complete post-installation tasks as required that may include verifying functionality of the computer, updating the BIOS, updating DMI, and other settings. How to restore CMOS to factory settings. Before you begin, remove the access panel, optical drive, 3.5-inch storage drive, 2.5-inch storage drive, and drive cage. Steps. Carefully release the CMOS battery from the socket retention clips that secure it on the motherboard and remove. Wait 30 seconds. Carefully secure the CMOS battery under the socket retention clips on the motherboard. CMOS factory settings are now reset. Important: you will now need to enter system BIOS and reset the clock in BIOS after this procedure. How to replace the optical drive bezel. Before you begin, remove the access panel and optical drive. Removal. With the optical drive bezel facing you, carefully press the bezel toward the right. While maintaining that pressure, slide the bezel out of the optical drive and remove. Replacement. Slide the optical drive bezel tabs into the cutouts in the front edge of the optical drive until the hooks engage and the bezel is secure. How to replace the optical drive bracket. Before you begin, remove the access panel and optical drive. Removal. Carefully pull the optical drive release latch on the optical drive bracket. While maintaining that pressure, slide the three pins on the optical drive bracket out of the optical drive and remove. Replacement. Starting with the leftmost pin, slide the three pins on the optical drive bracket into the holes on the optical drive until it is securely in position. How to replace the expansion card. Before you begin, remove the access panel, optical drive, 3.5-inch storage drive, 2.5-inch storage drive, and drive cage. Removal. If necessary, disconnect any cables from the expansion card. Rotate the expansion card retention bracket until it is fully open. If you are removing a graphics card, release the graphics card from the locking tab on the slot. Carefully slide the expansion card straight up and out of the slot on the motherboard and remove it from the chassis. Important: if you are not replacing the expansion card with another card, cover the open slot in the chassis with a metal slot cover. Replacement. Align the expansion card with the slot on the motherboard and insert the expansion card until it is fully seated. Rotate the expansion card retention bracket until it clicks closed. If you are replacing a graphics card, ensure the locking tab on the slot is fully in position in the notch on the graphics card. If necessary, connect any cables into the expansion card.